What's the difference between a Spyro game and a Sonic game? By now, Sonic would have drowned. Spyro has infinite breath somehow. Maybe he's got that magical breath! Hey everybody, 40 Warrior. Welcome back to Spyro 2, Ripto's Rage. We finished Idle Springs in the last part, and we questioned the game's logic evermore. And kind of cute how Sparks has his own little air bubble that he swims in. But anyway, this part, we've pretty much done everything we could in the first part of Summer Forest. Now it's just basically doing the second part of Summer Forest. We're just going through this little castle here. No, nothing to it, but... Well, now we have no choice in the matter. So anyway, another free Spyro move. Yeah, I kind of like doing that little jump out of water. I think it's kind of, you know, it's epic. Jumping out of the water like that takes serious force and serious athleticism to do. Do you ever see videos of people jumping out of water? It's absolutely incredible. You have to have phenomenal athleticism to do it. Ring for service. Housekeeping! Did somebody order a pizza? That didn't work.
You're well on your
That's
way, Spyro.
Stupid. That was
keep
stupid.
Collecting talismans to help us defeat Rip. Oh, and keep.
Keep collecting the orbs, keep collecting the talismans. Yes, 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 we know. And another ladder, which you can't do jack shit about. Which sucks, because there's an orb up there. We got Hurricos. We have another level right here, Sunny Beach. Oh yes, I remember Sunny Beach very well. Sunny Beach was actually one of the demo levels they gave you for this game. I kind of like the level. Hunter, I believe, works with the camera if you want it switched. Which I don't, because, well, I like it the way I have it. And to explore the rest of the castle, let's see. In at the portal!
Nice work, Spyro. The orbs you're carrying have activated.
Yay! Ocean Speedway. A flying level. They're now called speedways, not flights in this game, but you know, they act the same way. They have time attack and there's also a hidden challenge, which is kind of cool. Anyway, there's our fat bastard money bags again. But we also have this really interesting predicament. Seems like if we hit that button, we can't go through here because it shuts off the door, but this door opens. So what do? Well, we blow this thing sky high, and we jump up here, and we wrap around. It makes us jump! And collect the orb that's hiding here. Now, if we took the other split in the road, we'd end up down here. So, end up down here right now, it doesn't really matter. Might as well do it at some point. And there's that fat bastard moneybags, who I'm gonna blow by really quickly, because here is our boss level.
Hi, Spyro! This talisman door will only open if you have all 6 Summer Forest talismans.
You need all the talismans to do stuff.
Ripto and Crush will be waiting in the dungeon.
Yep. I say let them wait. They can stir a little bit, they can too while they're there. Yeah, that's kind of cold, even for my standards. Now, actually, when I first saw Colossus and Hurricos, I thought these were boss levels, to be honest, but they're not. Hurricos is probably one of the tougher ones, I'll do that later. Sunny Beach is a simple one. And... yeah, I need climb for that. Shit. I forgot I need climb for that. Hurricos doesn't require any special climb or dive. Aquaria Tower... oh, you didn't see Aquaria Towers yet, did you? Okay, let me get Aquaria Towers up. This guy right here.
Say, Spyro, you see this wall?
Well, I bet you're dying to know what's on the other side. So here's $500. Now you could either pay that in to see what's behind this wall right here, or you can take the $500. So the choice is yours. Deal or no deal? Yes, I did a cross-reference to game shows. What of it? I know they're not the same game show. I know one's like, let's make a deal, once deal or no deal. Yeah, we gotta do it anyway, because you have to do it to complete the game.
Yes, the sparkling beauty of those gems seems to have jogged my memory.
Yeah, sure. Just a money-grubbing bitch. And here's a quarry tower. This one you pretty much need to learn to dive, otherwise you'll never ever do anything in this level. But you need to dive to get to this point anyway, so you don't have to care. Now that you've pretty much done everything, dive is no longer really an issue because, well, you need dive to get to this area. And let's see, we're at 5 minutes right now, so do I want to do a speedway or do I want to do a level? Ugh, it's tough. Now, oh my god, you know what, the more I don't decide, the more I end up doing the flail. I'll do Hercus. Oh, he's got the 200 gems off of that. Ooh. Hercos can be a little bit of a pain in the ass. I think this is one of the first levels where you can legitimately, you know, die if you're not careful. So you see, we have jerks here. They stole a diode thing. But because there's so much more instant death opportunities here, that's why this level is, you know, slightly more dangerous. First, I'm gonna take care of this big guy right here, who's got a wrench. Now we did that.
We've always had trouble with the gear grinders, but now they've set up force fields to separate
an electrol. How cute!
You can use them to turn off the force fields. I think there's a diode around here somewhere, but my eyesight isn't what it used to be.
It's kind of impressive. I'm kind of impressed with how the game decides how to make certain enemies. I mean, not certain, it was certain NPCs, you know, certain characters like that. Like the Electrol right here. Now with the jump card. The jump card really didn't, you know, it was just a gopher, pretty much. No real, thing right here. But the Electrol is kind of cute, I think. So, yeah, you see the premise. Diode opens portal. We have a bunch of small windmills here, for no reason. And we have these enemies right here. That'll basically charge you once you get too close. And these small windmills have absolutely no reason for being here. Now, of course, if they have no real reason, or you can't find a reason, River Rat, by the way, fodder, then there must be some sort of ulterior motive behind them. And the answer is, yes, there is. It's a skill point. Get all the windmills, you get a free life. And look at that rainbow. Also, look at this enemy. Look at that rainbow, though. That's really nice. Oh my god, is that a rainbow or is that a sun? Yeah, that's definitely a rainbow and a sun. And here's a giant-ass rainbow right here. Right up close and personal. Admire it. It is awesome. That one jump can actually kill you if you're not, you know, if you take it too lightly, which I did once. Of course, now I'm smarter, I'm 24, and I'm wiser. And yes, I'm playing this game, and I'm 24. I don't care what people think about it. Isn't there some jackass left a comment in a Iron Man vid I did? It was like, why are you playing this game? Why are you playing a kid's game? It's not a kid's game, you retard. If you want to play a kid's game, play Dora the Explorer or something like that. But anyway, it doesn't matter to me what I play. I play games to enjoy them. I don't play games, you know, because of some stupid manliness thing. Because I'll be honest with you, if I really was so self-conscious about that, I would have tried playing every single sport I could. And, you know, be like one of those five-sport athletes who seem to get everything. Or if I really wanted to, I would have been the guy that got, like, you know, that graduated valedictorian, which I didn't either. I graduated fourth in the class, but that's beside the point. What isn't beside the point is these guys are jerks. Come here. Goodbye. There's a lot more enemies in Hercos, as you're gonna see. I mean, if I look, 22 of them. Double what Idle Springs brought to the table. Not bad. Most of the enemies you find are early on, and then just sort of, you know, calms down as time goes on. And you see right here, we have a portal. Needs 18 enemies to do anything about. Man, see, you know, we're ready to, not even halfway through level, we've already taken out 14 enemies. So yeah, I mean, this level right here is going by really, really, really quick. But the challenges are what makes it long. as you're gonna see. And right now, we got 17 enemies already, and, I don't think we even have half the gem. We don't even have half the gems for the level. The Herkos is much more dependent on... How is that for a combo? Nice! I was wondering how I was gonna do that, because, you know, the charge flame combo... of enemies can be kinda tricky if you don't know what you're doing. I'm sure we all know that, because, you know... You can't do both at the same time, unfortunately. Which, you know, whatever. Whatever, I say. I say whatever. This game is not designed to be hard, and I shouldn't be overthinking things. That's one thing that I do that I think I really need to do a better job, is I have overthought things in the past, and as a result, I end up doing very stupid things. That's one thing I learned when I was doing the internship. Because if I had a problem, like, say, if there was, like, some judgment call I had to make with $20 and the person made, you know, six digits.
Thank you, Spyro! You've
They pretty much said, it's only 20 bucks, don't worry about it. And see, we already got the talisman, and we barely even got half the gems for the level. Because this one is so tied to side quests, it's not even funny. I think it's probably one of those levels that's more brutal than others because of that. But the side quests are actually kind of dangerous. Well, one of them is. First, let's take the supercharge thing and just get the gems. And then we have to take out these giant stone things right here. As you see, we can't charge or flame them. That's where these things come in. And they slow the fan blades. How interesting. I wonder if we're ever going to be using the fan blades for something. Overly cliche at all? You slow down blades, and suddenly what? They become platforms? Yeah, they become platforms. Well, we're not completely done with these yet, because we have to go to the next area and take care of that. And... yeah. Alright, you have to take a sharp right, that's right. Alright. A sharp right is right. Nice, nice. Nice phrasing. Nice elocution. Nice hand-eye coordination. Nice sense of direction. And, well, that was retarded. So let's try again. Maybe we could be heroes. Just for one day. I'm not gonna do the fan blade thing yet. I'm gonna save that for the last thing I do in this level. Because there's one other side quest here, and... well, I'm clearly ignoring it for right now. Perfect. That's the way up to get to the fan blades, but first... let's take care of our little, friend over here. We noticed there's a completely irrelevant platform right here, and a completely irrelevant tunnel. I wonder what this means. The game doesn't make it very hard to find, the side quests. It's nice they have different things. You know, in the first game, it got kind of one-dimensional. But, same time. A lot more distraction.
Oh, these gear grinder thieves keep taking our lightning stones. If you can replace them all and activate our generator, I'd be very grateful.
This one's kind of difficult because the thieves are jerks. We have to do... and this is going to be kind of tedious, so I might speed this up. Is you have to take these stones... which you can't spit very far for whatever reason. And put them on these things. I suggest just basically taking care of two areas. Don't try taking care of all the areas, because as soon as you put too many of these things in slots, you won't, you'll basically take the thieves out of hiding and you get your opportunity to smoke them. You have to smoke all 10 before you can actually, you know, get the generator up and running. But you'll at least hear when they're coming, because you'll hear an alarm go off. Just cool. Hopefully this is more than enough to get him going. Hopefully. If not, I can at least, you know, keep working on this. Just assume I'm doing this over and over again. That's all I'm gonna say. Come on. Here we go. Come here. Despite their height, they're actually chargeable. And whenever you see an enemy over here, They're gonna try to jump over you, so if you jump up, you can cut them off. Kind of like the sleeping dogs from Spyro 1 and Toasty. And I've eliminated 4 thieves. Not bad. Now I just gotta do this a couple more times so I can actually scare out the rest of the thieves. Also, Spyro has a more determined look this time around. He looks angry. He's an angry dragon. Okay, come out, guys. Come out. I know you want to. Come here. You can come here, too. Piss off. Hey, where are you going? That was easy. If there's anything I can say about this challenge is that it's definitely tedious. Thank goodness that's the last, thief. Normally it takes like 4 runs of having to go up and back, up and back, putting stones down, putting them up again, just to lure them out again. It gets boring. It really does get boring. Not my favorite challenge at all. But we finished the generator, at least. So, yippee-ki-yay.
Thank you, Spyro. I found this shiny thing mixed up with our lightning stones. Please, take it as a reward.
Ooh, not the shiny thing! Oh no! The shiny thing! Running joke in my family, if my mom ever finds a shiny thing, it's always like we have to wait 20 more minutes for her. Because like, ooh, shiny thing! Let's face it, shiny things are, well, shiny things. And they're usually catching to the eye. But they're also very dangerous, I learned. Particularly if you're driving. Because then shiny things, well, divert your attention from the road, and if you divert your attention from something, well, you lose sight of what really matters, which is mainly, you know, could be, I don't know, maybe your life or something.
Spyro, do you see that big building over there? The gear grinders are using it to steal our electricity. Please help us by shutting down the machinery inside.
Oh no! They're siphoning off electricity! Whatever shall we do? What will we ever do if electric prices go up through the roof? I mean, what will he ever do? So, for all techies out there, for all geeks, for all nerds, for all gamers, I shall do this challenge and accept it. Anyway, the main challenge here is just basically jumping on these very slow-ass fan blades, which the charge jump makes so much more helpful because, boy, you cover more distance. If you cover more distance, you can actually do better work. You also have these receding platforms, which can be kind of annoying. Basically, that was not very hard at all.
Spyro, you've done well so far. You can have this little trinket for good luck. If you,
I did well. I've only done this for 30 seconds. I've already done this for 30 seconds, and they're paying me with an orb. That's pretty impressive.
The next glide.
But they make the jumps a little tougher now. You actually have to do the hover thing, or if you're me, you can actually do the charge jump. And completely fuck up. Oh no. What am I ever going to do? Now you have to do this again, which is kind of annoying. But you know, whatever. Whatever, yeah. What's over here? That's kind of strange, they actually left nothing there. They have to do it sometimes, otherwise, you have to keep people honest. That's one thing. Oh, there was a whirlwind right there, derp. Made it. The charge, jump, and hover routine. The best way to gain the maximum amount of altitude and distance. Okay, maybe not altitude, because you're actually jumping lower. You're just jumping at a better angle. You know what they say, you know, if you do something at a 45 degree angle, you have better success. Or you have better distance achieved. Oh, by the way. Final windmill. Skill point. And yes, I know I intentionally dropped down to get those straggling gems. Why didn't I get them before? Because I'm an idiot. Oh, well. Back to that, jumping platforms, yeah? Why am I starting to talk like a German? I have a terrible German accent, even though I'm part German. I am not a speedrunner, but I pretty much just speedrun that whole area. Just using the charge jump. Charge jump for the win, mofos. But the real thing, real difficulty of this is you can actually die doing this challenge now. As you plainly see. If you're not careful, well, you can die very quickly. And we finally made it to the end. We got every single gem.
Spyro, help! The switch to turn off the gear grinder factory is in that room, but, it's awfully noisy in there.
You're kidding me, right? The real reason they're stealing electricity is because of your cowardice? Whatever will you do if you have to pay 800 gems for an hour of electricity? Have you ever thought about the good of your kind? You despicable little piece of crap. You make me sick, bitch. Now I'm gonna be the manly dragon I am. Just walk right in this factory, nonchalantly hit one switch, and we're done.
Thanks for shutting down the factory. Here, I found this stuck between the gears. You can have it if you want.
I know what else is stuck between the gears. Your pride. Good luck trying to get that back, because I ain't helping you with that, dumbass. Well, anyway, we're done here. And Sparrow's giving him the look, and I'm glad he's giving the angry look. Sparrow, give him the angry look. Thank you. Alright, we're done with Hiroko, so we can actually leave this place. And now we get to watch these trolls do what trolls do best! Troll! Ooh, shiny object! Maybe helping these guys wasn't a good idea. Maybe we shouldn't have helped them. They're trolls after all. Well, anyway. We have completed Hiroko's, so it's a safe place to end it, I think. Next time, I'll probably do Sunny Beach. See you guys then, 40 Warriors signing off.